If I was to be asked what was my favourite memories of Doreen and what she meant to me, I wouldn't honestly know where to begin. But, okay, I will backtrack. Stuart and I were Alexandrian witches. And when we first heard about Doreen, we were told, oh, she's a recluse, she's gardenarian, she won't speak to you. Well, Stuart and I had been living in London and we moved to the Republic of Ireland. And we decided that we were going to research all the old Irish folklore and try to create not our own Book of Shadows, but take the existing Book of Shadows and make something more of it. Because when we were with Alex, there were no rituals for a requiem, for a wickening, or even for a marriage ceremony. All of these came out of Stuart. And he said, I want to put the bones, or I want to put meat on the bones of the Eight Sabbats for Witches. And that is how our book, Eight Sabbats, actually was born. Because originally, Eight Sabbats was followed by The Witch's Way, and they were two separate books. Later, they became conjoined and known as The Witch's Bible. Well, Doreen Valiente had been a great influence with her own books on Stuart and myself. And she was publishing with a company called Robert Hale. And we decided we would try Robert Hale as well, but we wanted an introduction. So Stuart wrote to Doreen. We never thought we'd get a reply, and we were invited down to Brighton. And she welcomed us with open arms. It was completely the opposite of everything we'd been told about this insanely marvellous woman. She sat down, she discussed Gardner, she discussed Sanders, she discussed the Eight Sabbats. And Stuart showed her the manuscript and she said, this is marvellous. And Stuart said, but the problem is there's bits of the Book of Shadows in there. And we know that you had a great influence on the writing of that. She said, my dears, it's my copyright. Publish and be damned. And she introduced us to Robert Hale, and that's exactly what we did. We published and we were damned, but we didn't care. And Doreen loved it. She was very, very proud of us. And as I said, she was such a gracious lady with a lovely sense of humour. And we visited her many, many times afterwards. And I gather that she saw me as her best friend, which was quite an honour. Because she was like a, I can't call her a sister because she was older than I was, but she was like a favourite aunt or a beloved grandmother. She held nothing back, no knowledge, everything about Gardner she talked about openly. And if she thought I'd made a mistake, she wasn't averse to telling me so. So I learned to mind my P's and Q's with Reenie, who was, that was Doreen's nickname. But at the same time, we'd literally embrace and hug each other every time we met. And we'd take her flowers, etc. But there was one time you never, ever went near Doreen's flat. And we talked to Doreen about this and also the gentleman concerned, and that was Ray Buckland. Now, Ray Buckland is a lovely man. He's very, very sweet. But that's another story.